Hello everyone! Dobry wieczór wszystkim. Witam wszystkich serdecznie na kolejnym wydarzeniu festiwalowym. So I welcome you all to yet again lovely event of the Polish Arts Festival, which is In Search of Identity Project Final. And I am accompanied today by amazing, beautiful and very talented woman, Ewa Kotuła and Anna Banko-Schumacher. And girls were essentially, now I just show you your faces. Now, so we were performing, we were delivering the project together, and this project has been, that's been the second edition this year. So last year, 2019 was the first project, and this year we have the second, we had the second project. Unfortunately, pandemic made it quite impossible for us to show the final project in the Bell Table, because normally it would be part of the theater night. And so what we have decided to do is we are going to show you last year's show, very much selected, because we have selected just one bit of a show, which will in a way represent what the workshops was about. And after playing this short video, we will have a discussion what was essentially project about. And then you will get this understanding of people, what was going on, and all that. So when watching the video, please note that the people in that enter the stage and get in contact with Ewa, they are not professional performers, okay? These are everyday people. These are ordinary people that just were searching for identity in the workshop. And I want you to notice what amazing things happened and how beautiful those people are in being themselves, truly themselves. So essentially, we'll start with the video first. Enjoy.
Thank you.
We can unmute ourselves. What memories? Oh my God, I feel so emotional. That was so emotional.
Yeah, it's amazing. Every time I watch it, it brings such a embodied experience every time, and it's something new because I've changed with the time as well. I'm new because new things happen for me, and I involved as a person, human being. But yeah, every time I watch it, it brings up the memory in my body. I'm actually kind of shaking right now. So, yeah.
I got emotional myself, I must say. We're only showing a part of it because it's been like the whole 15 minutes of the performance. But we have chosen that bit only just to keep that for conversation as well, and invite you guys to come to the theater to watch it sometime in the future as well. What I must say is, when I look at this performance and the girls, this is unbelievable that how beautiful people we have in our community, and how talented people, and how eager to explore.
Yeah, I'm going to add that it's amazing that we can all do that. It's not only few people who happen to take a part in the workshop. You can trust me, everyone can do that. You, a male, a female, child, an adult, if you just allow yourself to spontaneously move and trust your body, and it will happen magically. You won't believe what amazing moves you can do. It's every human can do it, believe me.
But I also think it's lovely to spend time together in the group of women, because I think we need to spend time together. We don't get much time to be and talk about every day and be together and talk about our problems and not only what good things as well. And I think that what Search of Identity gives as well, this freedom, because it's only women, so we can say a little bit more that sometimes we would be maybe a little bit afraid to talk about every day.
And work through body, with body, brings people together. a lot. It's not only the conversations, but when you in the workshop space and you're sharing not only your thoughts through verbalization, but through movement, it actually brings people so much closer. That's why this connectivity, this being together, even through a Zoom meeting, an online meeting, but by interacting, seeing each other, it's totally a different experience altogether.
And it is something that if I can ask you to mute your phones if we're not speaking, because I know that on the live stream there is echo, even if we can't hear it here. I'm just getting it. So if I can just say that In Search of Identity project, it was an experimental one in the first year. We have decided, three of us, to gather people together that only were willing to experiment a little bit with their body, experiment with their feelings, experiment with their voice and with emotions, and just go into those spaces through the physicality of their body. And as Eva said beautifully, the memory that your body has. Everything, every emotion is stored in your body, and essentially through the body, we don't need the language, common language. We don't need to speak any language. You know, it's enough that we are in the presence of each other, and then we allow our body to speak, and those beautiful meetings happen. So Anna was doing a lot of the voice workshop with people. So she was working on them reaching out to their vocal cords, but from the heart. Okay, it wasn't about technicalities of it, because you know we essentially wanted people to make sure that they are heard, that their voice is out there. You know, that their voice is expressed, whether through body movement, through the sounds, and I mean sounds, not some words, but sounds, because we share the sounds regardless of the language. And what we have actually observed was amazing connection between the people and this humble giving themselves to the process. So they were subject of the process, but they were taking it very personally. And what you could see on the video, that wasn't rehearsed. Okay, the girls knew that this is the exercise that Eva is going to perform with them, which was essentially one of the exercises that was during the workshops. But whatever was happening on the stage wasn't rehearsed by the girls. It was from their heart. Yeah? If I may ask Anya and then Eva to share their experiences of the workshop, because we have to take turns because of the echo, so I'm afraid I have to mute myself again.
Well, during the search of Identity 1 and 2, I wanted, personally myself, I wanted to focus a lot about the breathing techniques, diction, of course, as well, the strength of voice, the voice impostation and singing. But I think in a lot of ways, when we're learning music, singing, playing the music, we never learn how to improvise. Obviously, that's what Justina was saying about that it's such a great skill to have it. And I think through those techniques, breathing and exercising through breathing, like, you know, strength of the voice, we can actually learn that. And definitely In Search of Identity is the best way to learn this. I'm not expecting that after a couple of times of that course, someone will be able to go and sing big massive arias or something like that. I'm more expecting people to find their voice, that it is somewhere inside. And even if you say you can sing, I show you how to get this voice out, actually. So through those exercises of breathing, That's what we actually gained. It was such a short of time, so practically impossible to learn a lot more difficult things actually, but just to get an examples that would be the best to illustrate actually these methods. So fantastic, because loads of girls didn't realize that they are not breathing properly. Loads of us, especially these days, I think, are living in such a stress, and especially because of COVID, because of lack of contact together. So those kind of exercises are definitely helpful in nearly everyday life. So I think this vocal technique is very good to understand that it's not only we need to learn how to sing, but how to breathe, how to use our voice. We talk every day, like, you know, most of people are talking on the phone about 20 times a day actually, and they don't know probably how to use their voice actually to not destroy it actually. And I think most of the girls actually on the In Search of Identity 1 and In Search of Identity 2 found their voice and found what do they need to use it for. And it was just amazing how through a couple of times only they were changing into actually singers, to be honest, because until the very last day we actually get to sing a song together, and they're finding it actually so brilliant and fantastic, and they're like, oh my god, I never knew that I can sing, but it is possible. And I think to explain to people that it's not that difficult, that it's just you have to find yourself and relax. But I was absolutely amazed, and I can't wait for another one, and I really, really hope that we will be able to organize another and another and another In Search of Identity.
Yeah, Eva.
I just thought you're going to take a voice for a second. Anna, thank you for what you said, because I had to write it down because you said they found their voice, and I'm going to add they also found their bodies. So it's like becoming a whole through the workshop, through working with different techniques. Each time the experience is different and so amazing in its own way, because the participants are different and they bring in their own history and experiences. We were working a lot with deepening the connection with the body. We were looking at the defense mechanisms. We were trying to figure out how to nourish yourself when we notice, because it's not about getting rid of them. You know, they essential, they helping us to live and deal with situations. It's about becoming friendly with them. So basically during the exercise, when someone felt quite sad or happy, we were actually just looking at it, you know, just notice this emotion and be with it and see what you can do for yourself to make yourself feel better. We were telling stories through the body. We were using authentic movement. We were using intuitive movement. So many things happen. It's very hard to put it in a few words, especially, yeah. Yeah. So I'm just going to add that every single person amazed me, really amazed me, in the way being honest with yourself, being open to share the story through the movement, because it's not easy. It's not easy. But when you open that door, it changes everything. It changes your inner child. It heals you as a person as well. Thank you so much.
Oh, Eva and Anya, we could be talking about this forever, and I'm really grateful for your words, because essentially the first project in 2019, we could actually do it together, three of us together. So we were working all together. In the pandemic in this year, 2020, due to restrictions, we had very much limited number of participants. And because of that, everybody had to work with their group on their own. So that was also a different experience for all of us, like for the girls and for us as trainers. But I think it was amazing to see how those three ways of working were absolutely joined together, and they were combined, and they were working for one another. And at the end, when we were sharing all those experiences that we had with the participants, they were just so emotionally organic. And the girls, because this year we had the girls, last year we had one male participant, which was also very amazing in terms of the energy break and energy shifts and all of that. But some of the feedbacks that we got from the participants was that they have, for example, they didn't realize that they haven't been in those spaces for many years, that they have abandoned themselves. They have abandoned their bodies, or they have forgotten, neglected their bodies. They have neglected their voice, and thinking that, you know, in all ways of aspect, it's not only about production of voice, but it's also about just coming back into this inner child that will ask, and you ask yourself questions, but what is it, who I am, and what is it that I want? So we were doing a lot of different exercises as well when we were dealing with those emotions, when we were trying to reach out to them, and then what Eva said beautifully, reflect back. So reflect back, you know, mirror it. And the one of the most powerful exercises was when you actually mirror what you see. And you have another person mirroring you, and you have another person mirroring you. So then you look at yourself from a totally different perspective, and you're going into those spaces like, oh my God, is this what is happening? So this year we also were exploring masks, and we were working with masks, different aspects of masks. And we had like a theatrical mask that we worked with, and just to see where it will take us. And then there was a lot of fantastic conversations about the mask and its history and its connotations and the way it makes you feel and what do they do. So that was very contemporary as well with whatever is going on now in the world and how the mask makes you feel and what happens to you when you're wearing it. Does it empower you, or does it take the power away from you? Or does it makes you a nobody, or does it make you somebody? So these were all of those questions. And then how you feel expressed through your movement and you express through your voice. So it's not only your head. We try to switch off the head and make sure that the person can go back into the body. You know, and that was body work, was very much Eva's work. She was like squeezing the girls to go into those spaces, but very gently, because she's the best, she's the most gentle person that I know when it comes to working. And Eva is also doing TRE therapy, which is trauma and stress release therapy. So working with the body emotions, and her alchemy of movement hopefully will be open soon. So if you ever want to have a perfect person to work with on releasing tension and trauma that is in your body, I couldn't say that, you know, there isn't a better person to go to than Eva, because she will look after you properly, you know? Absolutely, yes. And Anya, our voice master, and whatever she has done with the girls was amazing. And the girls were coming out and saying, oh my God, I can actually sing. Or, oh my God, I never knew how to breathe, you know? And finally, somebody explained that to me, you know, took me into that space that sometimes is very physical as well, you know? When you know how those physical mechanisms work, then you know how to activate them. If you don't know what's going on, you just don't know how to activate them. So that was, you know, amazing. So what I want to say as well Yeah, get out of your head and go back into body. Exactly, Anka. Anka Minescu is giving us beautiful comments, which I'm going to read in a minute. And we might also ask Anka if you wish to come in and we can have a discussion, conversation. Yes, reactivating inner powers. You guys are reactivating inner powers. That's just perfect. Amazing what you just said. Yeah, the powers of the body. Go in, Eva, go in.
coming back to the COVID experience, because it was about the COVID experience as well. During this workshop, we're looking at, because we don't realize how our bodies are affected by, you know, the pandemic. It's not only stress in our head, but it's actually the tension in our body and how we get, we kind of self-isolate, even unconsciously, and that's in our bodies. Our body tries to protect us all the time. So it was amazing to see how they kind of came out of that little box we created, even unconsciously during the pandemic. And during the workshop, you could see, and we had those talks about how, what happened to us, you know, how we experience in it, because it's difficult for every single person. And I think that's why working with body and looking and voice and being honest with what I feel and being in touch with it, it's so important these days. So I encourage everyone to sing along at home, you know, play music, sing along, use your voice, use your body, dance when you, I don't know, washing the dishes, or, you know, just do it like a child. Just let yourself do it and you will feel so much better. Thank you.
Anya, do you want to come in?
Yeah, definitely. Eva is right. You have to try to practice every day. And when that was every time when we were meeting girls in one or two, we were saying that you have to try what you learned there. You have to try to practice. So about voice practice, it was try to practice your breathing. As Justyna said, especially the last In Search of Identity, Anya, she was absolutely shocked. She was like, oh my gosh, I actually don't know how to breathe. And she was saying to everyone that Anna told me how to breathe. And it's actually so funny because breathing is something that happens automatically. We don't have to tell ourselves, okay, now I'm going to breathe in and now I'm going to breathe out. This is something what happens automatically, isn't it? It's just our brain does it for us. Like, you know, we don't have to do it. We don't have to think about it. But as we said, it's a special technique that you can get your full breath, actually. There's loads of people, they don't know about it, that they're breathing only in halfway, that they don't get the full capacity that can go inside you, actually. So, yeah, it is very important when you're told these things and you try that it works, to practice it every day, to think about it, even when you're in bed, even if you, as Eva said, washing dishes, if you're walking with your dog, if you feel stressed, if you feel sad, if you're happy, just to see what happens with your body. How do we breathe? How do we laugh? When we're laughing, how does it happen? Do we laugh because we want to laugh? How do we get this voice out of us? Like, you know, so definitely sometimes such a simple things are happening without our brain and we don't know about it, isn't it? We don't do, okay, now I have to make a step. Okay, you think about it because you have to go up the stairs, for example, that you have to make that step. But then after that, another and another and another one is just happening automatically. So thinking about, if it happens automatically, can I make it better? Can I do something about it? Like, you know, so expressing yourself every day and working on it is just something amazing. I'm actually in the middle of learning this new things as well, because I'm back to college this year. So I'm learning also. I'm a student as well now. So I'm back to these things that I forgot a little bit about, like, you know, myself even. And it's just amazing to that I'm finding in myself that I was making these mistakes as well. Of course, nobody's perfect, and we are learning all life, isn't it, about new things. But when you are teaching someone, you forget about yourself. You're giving people ideas. Now try to do this and now try to do that. But then you forget about yourself. So it's great for me now, actually, to be a student as well, that I can learn it myself. So I already have thousands of different ideas for next In Search of Identity. So watch the space.
I love that. Well, Anka is saying that breathing properly also deactivates the fight, flight, survival mode of the subconscious brain. We can actually rest and relax only with good breathing. I really want to learn too. I know the theory, not the practice. And I think this is also what In Search of Identity is about, that we know very much, we know everything, okay? Everybody knows everything. We read millions and thousands of books. We have done millions and thousands of workshops, but it's all in here. You know, we're still staying in this bit. And we're not in here. We're not here. Like, we're not in touch with ourselves. We can touch ourselves, but what is it? You know, what is it that I'm touching? Who is it? Where is this person? And how much was it hurt in the past that affects his presence? And where is it in the body that it hurts? And where is that hurt that something Eva loves to work with? She's like amazing to do the work on that. You know, where is it? So she will go there with you and you will shake it out. You will shake it out. So, and then once you have actually shaken everything off, you can go back into your true self and the beauty comes out and the organic way comes out. And then I think essentially it's about meeting, the whole workshop is about meeting yourself, but not on the brain level, but on the very much experience level of yourself, very much tangible, you know? Very tangible. And you can enjoy life so much more when you are in touch with yourself, your true self. That's true, Anka. Yeah. That's a comment we're getting, so we're just commenting on it. That's so true. When you just enjoy your life, and then even from my experience, I can say the smallest of thing can make you happy. You don't have to go, and we've been discussing that with Anka on her workshops, like during the festival. The smallest of things make you happy, you know? You don't have to get a new car to be happy. You can get a flower from your garden, and that is the most wonderful thing that has ever happened to you. Physical memory, it's also Anka's quote, physical memory is perhaps even stronger than the cognitive. Body keeps the score, and we forget their power if we don't use our bodies. This project is really cool. Will you continue? Oh, yes. Well, I have to say this is very important. This project was funded by Limerick City and County Council and Creative Island through Made in Limerick grant to 2020. So essentially, we are applying for it every year. And we don't know if it's going to happen or not, if the application will be successful or not. However, with the feedbacks that we're getting and with the strong people behind us, we do really hope that if we go for it next time and the grant is there available, then we will be able to say, yes, we're doing part three, or we're doing part one, two, three again, because that's a process, you know, that's a process. So if you are interested in any of those workshops, please keep in touch with us through our website, polishartsfestival.ie, or email us at polishartsfestival@gmail.com, or check us out on Facebook or other social media. We will be letting you know if something like that is out for grabs, because the places go quickly. Like this year, we were so disappointed that we had to put on a waiting list a lot of people, but because it's just the restrictions didn't allow us to have more. And so it was first come, first serve basis. We couldn't do anything else.
But I think it's important as well to say, Justyna, that we were thinking to do two groups, so group in English and group in Polish, so that we would be able to get Irish girls, men's, boys, women's, to come in and enjoy it as well. Because, so far we had only one and two was in Polish, but we don't want to say that we won't be able to do it. We would love to do it in English as well. So I think that's important to say as well, that plans are there.
Definitely. And the workshop, it's, you know, we're not working on the brain, so we're working with the body. So the language doesn't really matter. It was that the first and second part, it was Polish audience that have responded. So that's why it was done with the Polish guys. But essentially, we want international crowd to work with us, because at the end of the day, it's all about shared experience. And we all share the same human experiences, regardless of the culture, background, beliefs, disbeliefs, together as one. It's the theme of this festival. When we are together, we are as one. When we are one, we are also, you know, together with other people, because inside, there isn't a Polish person, Romanian, French, Portuguese, whatever. You are a human with everything that is there, with body, essentially put into the body, you know? So I don't know if there are any questions or if there's anything the girls would like to add. I will see if there's any comments on Facebook. Oh yeah, we have some lovely comments on Facebook. Now I want to show you a few pictures maybe as well from the workshop, which I have to go and do the screen sharing. One second. Now. Now. So this is one of the pictures from the previous one, because there were a few performances that were there. We just showed you one. We might actually show you the first one as well. If we have a few minutes, we might see. So these are our participants experiencing and working with the voice. Okay. I'm just thinking, is there any other questions that we might have? Because I think maybe to end that, we can show the first part. I don't know how you feel, ladies. Is there anything else that you would like to add?
I would like to say that I'm hoping that we will be able to do another In Search of Identity. And I'm hoping that we will get loads of participants from all over the world, not only from Poland, not only from Ireland, but everyone else. And I'd love to be able actually to show everyone how fantastic is to be on the In Search of Identity, and how many more experiences actually you can get, and about your body, about your voice, about yourself really actually, and how important it is to spend this time with loads of fantastic people, because we don't really do much for ourselves actually, to be honest. We're so busy with everyday life, and we all have so many problems. So sometimes those couple of hours on that one Saturday means so much actually, and you can gain absolutely so much, actually. So I really, really hope that we will be able to do it, because I'd love to meet more people. Fingers crossed, exactly.
And I'm going to add, remember that everybody has a body, everybody has a voice, and remember about it and use it. Use it. Then you will feel alive and you will actually gain so much more energy from being in touch with yourself and using your organic body and voice and everything what's inside. Don't be shy to get in touch with it. Yeah. So I'm looking forward to see people joining us. It's actually experience not only for our participants. It's amazing experience for us. We learning so much as well. Because I think working with the body, you observing yourself, what is happening to me when someone reacts this way or another way? And you need to kind of scan yourself and see if there is something new every time. So it's beautiful because it works both ways, absolutely, every time. Yeah, so please join us.
Amazing. We're looking forward to working with you guys, three of us already, with In Search of Identity projects. We're hoping to be able to offer that to the wider audience. And it makes us, as Eva said, so enriched. Like every facilitator, each one of us after the workshops was a different person. Because as Eva said, whatever is happening to the participant is also reflecting on me, on my body, on my emotions, on my history, on my memories. And by learning to look at yourself, what happens to me, that's very healing process, you know? It's a very healing holistic process. So we're looking at art, and in this way I can say art has a power of healing, because essentially art, to be true, has to be organic, you know, to be, you know, you can create whatever for sale if you wish to. But I think the beauty of it is that artists that we carry in ourselves, everybody is an artist. There isn't like, you know, you are an artist of your life. So you create amazing things for yourself. Make sure you look after yourself and treat yourself with a, you know, with a gentle gentleness and gentle touch. So I think we're just going to finish and say goodbye to you by showing you the first piece. And then we're just going to end this meeting. And if you have any questions, please feel free to write to us on Facebook. It's going to be available on YouTube later on. PolishArtsFestival@gmail.com. or polisharts.ie. So love you to all, and we'll say goodbye with the film.
Justina, I'm sorry. We're just gonna say a little bit about this piece, because people want to know. Actually, the girls created it themselves. They got a team, and they were working in a creative process to tell the story. So it's actually their choreography in total. We only added the music, so it's a creation by the participants. So enjoy.
Okay, everyone. So thank you for listening. And we wish you all the best. And see you hopefully soon. Bye-bye.